What's up, guys? It's Missy. I'm back with another SimCity Build-A video. And I had put up a video this morning talking about the production guide that me and a group member made together yesterday. So you guys should be thanking CPT as well for putting this together and compiling up some charts and stuff. Now, I have since taken those two videos down because there was a minor error on the chart that we put together yesterday. It didn't actually affect the items that you guys produce, but I didn't want to put it out there if it was actually, you know, an error. So, that being said, I'm going to briefly explain why this was so hard to put together. So, when you guys are looking at the list of items from each shop, and you guys are trying to figure out which ones turn the highest profit. And I'm going to kind of explain how this chart works, okay? So, the very top of the line that says item, that's the item, obviously. This is the max price that item will sell for. This is the per minute value that you make per minute, obviously. And then mats means materials that go into making that item, and then this is the profit that you would make. So, with flour, right, it costs 2 techs and 2 seeds. That totals out to be 240. So, if you were to sell those items separately, that's the price that you would get. If you were to combine those two and make flour, this is the profit that you would make. All right, that's out of the way. So, the reason that this chart is, I guess, such an accomplishment is because what most people do, and when you look up like videos on how to earn max simoleons, what they do is they come up to you and they go, okay, the barn, the best item in the barn to make is flour. And then they walk away and they say, okay, the best item to make in the donut shop is donuts. But they don't tell you how to produce those all day long. They don't tell you what to make at night. They don't tell you how many you're going to produce in a day. They don't tell you if you were to purchase the materials and combine them together that you could make more profit making other items. So to make these items, the materials needed for these, that turns the highest profit. But let's say that you purchased some of the needed materials. That changes things. Now, that being said, for example, flour, if you look at this chart, okay, so if you look at the per minute value, flour is at $23.75 per minute. Now, if you look at the profit list, the highest profit number is beef, right? So a lot of people, they look at this list and they go, okay, beef turns the highest profit because you get $440 for every one beef that you make. Okay, that's not correct. All right, and I'm going to tell you why that's correct, but you're not going to turn the highest profit making beef. And why is that? Well, I can tell you why. Because if you look here, beef takes 120 minutes. So that's 2 hours. You can make a total of 5 flour for every 1 beef. So if a flour takes 24 minutes, what you're going to do is you're going to divide the 24 into 120, and then you're going to see that it equals 5. So if you're producing beef and I'm producing flour and we both run our shops for 2 hours, right? I'm going to end up with 5 flour and you're going to end up with 1 beef. You're going to make $860 and I'm going to make $2,850. That is why looking at the profit list and just going, oh, okay, that one's the most, that's what I'm going to make. No, that's not the most profitable item though. Another common mistake people make, they make burgers because it's the highest priced item in the game, but it is absolutely not the most profitable and it really should never be made. And I'll explain that when we get to the fast food shop. Now, the reason that I'm redoing this video is because the materials for cream and the materials for corn were off just by a little bit. Even though they're an item that you're not going to produce with this building production plan, I still wanted to make that correction. So I have a written, I have a written guide. Now this guide is based off of a max level. So what we did was we compiled up a list of every item in the game and made it to where, and we wrote up a production plan that says you're going to make this item per this shop and turn this profit. And then you're going to make this item at this shop based off these materials that you've purchased. So we kind of did two different plans here. And let me tell you, we put a lot of work into this. It was like 6 fucking hours of work, okay? So you guys should put in the comments thanking CPT. Shout out to him that he helped make this because we both endured the headache. So first things first, you're going to be running. This build is off, is based off of a maximum time discount. So what I mean by that is every shop is going to be a 3-star shop, okay? You're also going to want all 11 slots in every shop unlocked for this to work. I mean, not really for it to work, but for it to be beneficial at night, okay? Now, I should clear this up because there was some confusion with a group member last week that if I say it's a 16-hour day to an 8-hour sleep, that does not include you waking up in the middle of the night and refilling your shop after 4 hours. So it's not, like, let's say I was to tell you at level 18 to make 11 tables at night at a level 18. That's not 8 hours worth of tables. It's all, you're going to bed for 8 hours. So you put up all 11 tables because you went to sleep. I'm not accounting for 8 hours of tables. So yeah, no. All right. First things first. 16-hour day to an 8-hour night is daytime, you're going to produce 40 times flour. So you, and we're going to go through the factory, the stuff you're going to need for your factories afterwards. So 40 flour equals 16 hours. At night, you're going to make 6 melons and you're going to fill the additional 5 slots that you have available with flour. So if you have enough techs and seeds, go ahead and use a 12 times token on flour. Now, we are going to briefly talk about tokens, but I'm not going to get into that right this very minute. Now, the donut shop, you're going to run on a total of it's going to be a 24-hour thing because you're going to be making donuts full-time in your donut shop. No other items get made, all right? If you look at my notes right here, it says, if you buy the cream to make rolls. And I also compiled a list of items that you're going to want to purchase every time you see them on the global market and what to make with those items. I've made this really easy for you guys. Put a lot of work into this shit. All right. Building supplies. Store. You are going to have a 16-hour day to an 8-hour sleep. Now, if you're on the game every 44 minutes for 16 hours, hang on just a second here. Okay, yeah. So every 44 minutes, you're going to make 11 nails. It's going to total out to be a total of 240 nails. 240 nails. Okay. I have the plan, and then I have the charts that we made. So you guys can screenshot this. I'm also going to put these up on the Discord. They're actually up on our Discord. So it says, if you can't check in every 44 minutes, that you're going to buy minerals and make 60 bricks. Okay? Now, your nighttime run, you're going to make 8 cement and 3 glue for gnomes. All right? So that's basically what was said right here. You're going to make 8 cement and 3 glue. Now we're on to the hardware shop. Now, this one is what's... This one's going to cause you some problems here. So, you're going to need... This is a 16-hour day to an 8-hour sleep again. So, you're going to need a total of 60 hammers. And with those 60 hammers, you're going to make 60 chairs. That comes out to a total of 11 hours and 11 minutes. You're going to need to make 38 tape. So 30 of those tape are going to go to your caps, and 8 of them are going to go for your blue ticks. That totals out to be 10 hours and 13 minutes. You're going to also need 37 shovels, and that is for 31 grass and 6 saps. That comes out to 14.8 hours. So all of this added up together equals 36 hours and 4 minutes. That is not possible to make in a 24-hour period. So what I suggest to do is make your 60 hammers, and that'll do your 11 hours and 11 minutes, okay? That's going to leave you with 4 hours and 49 minutes left in your 16-hour day where you can choose whether or not you want to make tape and shovels or just tape. I recommend just making the tape and then making shovels at night. Anytime that you see tape or shovels on Global, purchase them. Because if you read my notes here, it says, nighttime, make 11 shovels. That comes out to 264 minutes. You will need to buy the rest. So right here it says, total needed tape left is going to be 20. And total needed shovels after the 11 that you made on your night production is going to be 26, right? Okay. So right there, 20 tape, 26 shovels. If you need to screenshot this, right there. Okay. And again, I'm going to turn my camera for like that. Wait. Okay, go ahead, screenshot it. Or just go to our Discord. Okay. Now, we're on to the garden store. Okay. Garden shop. This is the chart that we made. So, and I honestly wanted to do this with screenshots. That's how I recorded the first one, but I wanted to actually show you guys both papers here. Okay, daytime is going to run for 12 hours and 40 minutes or so, I think, is what it was. Okay, yeah, so 44 minutes. Produce 31 grafts. That's going to take you 744 minutes. Your nighttime, you're going to make 6 saps and 3 gnomes. Now, that's going to total out to be 10 hours and 8 minutes. So what I've done here is you're going to make 31 grafts all day long, right? Now, before you go to bed, you're going to put up your 6 saps and your 3 gnomes, and that is going to run for a total of 10 hours and 8 minutes. So even though we've been doing our normal days as a 16-hour day to an 8-hour sleep, technically this would be a 12.44-hour day to a 10.8 sleep. All right? Now, with the 46 remaining minutes that you'll have available to you, you can choose to either make 1 grass, which would leave you a total of 22 minutes left over. Or you can... Honestly, yeah, that's what you're going to have to do. You're going to have to do that. Plus, you know, you also have to account for any downtime where maybe you opened your game late. You know, this is a very strategic plan. There's no room for, like, 1 minute, 1 second, 30 second. You know what I mean? So that's It's going to have to be adjusted to your lifestyle and how often you rotate your shops, how often you find shovels, things like that. So, I mean, this is just the general guide that you want to follow and the most money that you could possibly make without using tokens. Okay? Now, notes. Read my notes. It says, if you're able to buy any cement and glue, make gnomes over the grass as it turns a higher profit when the mats are purchased. Okay? Now, again, this is what I was saying when I said that a lot of time was put into this. Most people would just come up to you and be like, look, grass turns a high profit, make grass. A lot of people aren't going to sit here and go through each list of, well, if you purchase this, then this happens. And if you don't purchase that, you know what I mean? So trust me, every possible variable was thought about when making this production. Okay. So if you can purchase the cement and the glue at any time, buy it up and make gnomes over grass. Okay. Saps made are for the nighttime melons used for pink drinks. So if you remember, all right, I got to upload this, you guys, and then I'll get, this one's going to have three parts.